So in today's video, we're going to be doing a deep dive into what I consider to be one of the best, but also most overlooked business model for directory sites, paid online communities. We're going to be diving into how they work, how much money you can make off them, what the best strategy is for getting them off the ground, and how well they scale. Let's get into it. Friends, what's going on? Welcome back to the channel. So today we're going to be talking about the first of a few business models that we're going to be doing a deep dive on how to monetize your directory website. Now, before we get into it, I want to make a shout out to one of our community members that recently launched their directories, John from Fittings Pro. Now, Fittings Pro is a directory that helps you find golf club fitters near you. Now, I'm going to say straight off the bat, I know nothing about golf, so hopefully I don't butcher this. But from my limited understanding, basically what this directory does is that if you are someone that is into golf, it pays to have your golf clubs fitted, meaning that a professional looks at your swing, all that type of stuff, and then makes recommendations based on that. So the way it works is that you can simply look at your location, wherever you are, you can set your preferences for the types of clubs that you like, and then golf fitters will basically provide you with a list of fitters that you can check out. And just like that, you'll have where you can learn a little bit more about the fitters, what kind of brands they work with, how much it all costs, and then all you need to do is click on visit the website, call the shop, and that is a great example of a business directory in a very specific niche that you can set up with no-code tools. So big shout out to John. Now, typically, once your business gets to this stage, you'll start to see that you're gonna start attracting traffic. And then as soon as that traffic starts to increase, you'll also start to see that vendors start reaching out to you because now they are obviously interested in getting listed on your site. And that oftentimes leads to the big question, well, now that we're here, how do I actually make money off this site? And in today's video, we're going to be diving into what I consider one of the best business models to start off with: online communities. So how does the paid community business model work in relation to directories? Now, the way it works is that your directory essentially becomes a lead generation tool for a paid online community. Now, why do I like paid online communities? Well, to me, they cover the trifecta of good businesses. First of all, it generates recurring revenue for you because the go-to business model is typically a monthly or an annual fee. Then, specifically with community businesses, the actual value of your community scales exponentially over time because as more members start to join, the more conversations you have, the more conversations you have, the more there is for new members to reference in the future. So over time, these platforms get better and better and better and ultimately more useful to your vendors. And then finally, and this is going to be relevant to most people who are still undecided on how to monetize their site, this is a super easy thing to set up and it's really, really cheap to test. Now, there are still a lot of things that we need to consider about this model though. So in today's video, I'm going to be going over how this model works and what kind of directories I think this model is best suited to. Then we're going to be talking about one of the things that can really make or break your community, which is how to develop a really good offer for your community members and how you can actually test it with some of your vendors in your directory before you commit to the whole build. Then we're also going to be talking about how much money you can realistically make off this money, off this model, and how much it costs. This is then going to lead me into the tools that I'd recommend using for this. Then we're also going to quickly touch on some of the keys to success and how you running this well can actually allow you to scale your community offer to the moon. So this here is a very useful, a very important business model to consider if you are just getting into it, if you are still undecided on how to best monetize it. And most importantly, this business model here is better than doing affiliate marketing or charging some listing fees that are prone to churn. Now, the main reason why I wanted to start off with this business model was because I was actually inspired by one of our community members, Peter, who set up a directory called the Spokes Collective. Now, the Spokes Collective is similar to the running directory website that I've been talking about on this channel. It basically helps sports enthusiasts find sport events. So in this case, running races. And in here, You can kind of come in, you can kind of search for races by discipline, and then it will basically list out all of the different events happening near you. You can then get more information about the event, and then if you want to go ahead and sign up, you can do so. Now, the customers that actually sign up to use the Spokes Collective are race organizers. And the problem that they are trying to solve is that they are responsible for selling out the events. So every single time someone reaches out to them, their primary goal is to get help with marketing. Now, when I looked into this with the running directory and started talking to different vendors, I had a very similar experience to Peter. And that is that a lot of the customers that we work with all share the same problems. They all need to figure out how to do their own marketing, how to sell out the events. They need to find sponsors. They need to figure out, you know, certain things around operations and legal things. And ultimately, the thing is that everyone kind of has to figure this out for themselves. And so the idea of building an online community is to basically take all of these common problems that a niche is solving individually and bringing them all into one central place so that everyone can actually support each other, share resources, and find answers faster. Now, if you want to see a real practical example of an incredibly well-executed niche directory, one that I'm a part of and that I've been a part of for years is Everthink Marketplaces. Now, this community is all about helping marketplace founders build their business. Now, this is obviously incredibly niche. Now, I've been part of this for about 5 years now, and I contribute primarily in the no-code and low-code marketplace section. But obviously, there's more to building a marketplace than just the no-code side of things. You need to learn about monetization, marketing, SEO, and all those types of things. And one of the main benefits of being part of this community is that I now get access to pros and experts in different parts of this niche. And so what makes this so incredibly useful is that whenever I have any big questions around one of my marketplaces or directories, I know that this is the place where I can go to for answers. Now, a very interesting point about this is that Everthink Marketplaces actually has its own directory or marketplace in this case, where people can basically hire marketplace experts. Now, I get quite a few inquiries through this, which is awesome, but if this was my primary reason why I signed up to this site, I would probably have expectations around how much traffic or how many leads I get. But because this is only a secondary thing and the primary value that I get is from the forum, any work or any value that I get from being in the directory is actually a massive bonus, which makes it even more likely that I want to stick around. And so ultimately, when thinking about your directory, you want to think about what are the big problems that you want to solve for your customers and how can you do that beyond just listing them in your directory. Now, one of the main reasons why you want to do that is because now that your value is not primarily focused on the amount of clicks or emails that you generate for someone, but the actual value of the community as a whole, you can just simply charge a lot more. So the way that Everthink Marketplaces charges is it's $700 a year or $99 a month. And if you have a very good specialized niche community, you can just charge a little bit more than just for a listing fee itself. And that is because the value is just so much. And especially if you're joining now, really late, the value is already coming from all of the extra contributions that people have made. So ultimately, if your primary way of wanting to monetize is through, say, a listing fee, this is something that will allow you to charge way more and it will be way, way stickier. Now, another big reason why this business model is so popular is because it's also incredibly easy to test and cheap to set up. Now, the tool that I use for my community forum and the tool that Mike uses at Everthink Marketplaces is Circle. Now, the main reason why Circle is so popular amongst community builders is it essentially replaces the need for you to have 8 or 9 different subscriptions in order to run one community. So some of the key features that they have is obviously the community forum, which is beautiful. You can have it on your phone and it's got a nice interface. But then they also have tools like inbuilt chat. So that replaces the need for something like Slack. You can organize your own events and you can even host live streams in here, which again, replaces the need for something like Zoom. You can also list courses in there, which will replace something like Teachable. Then you can also set up email marketing from inside of your which means now you don't need to sign up to something like MailChimp. And it just keeps going. They have ways for you to manage payments. They recently launched a website builder I'm going to be talking more about in a future video. And all of this comes in one tool. Now, how much cost to use Circle? Now, again, instead of having to pay for 8 different subscriptions that would probably add up to around $250, $300 a month, you can actually just get started on their professional plan. So this only costs $89 a month, and it pretty much gives you access to all the key features that you're going to need in order to get started. So you'll get access to the courses, events, the discussion forums, the website building tool, you know, the branding, all that kind of stuff. And then once you get to the point where things start to scale up and you need to start automating things, you can move up to the business tier where you'll get access to features like workflows or the API and maybe some, you know, AI features like the content copilot. And then once you're fully underway, you can then move on to the enterprise plan, and that will give you access to a whole bunch of really fun features like the AI agents, AI workflows, all those types of things. So ultimately, the key here is that if you want to test your business model, see whether or not this is something that could work, it will cost you at worst $89 per month until you hit the cancel button. And so ultimately, it's a very low risk business model to experiment with. So another thing that is really cool about this model is that there's actually a very predictable process that you can use in order to get your vendors to join your community. Now, if you have set up your directory, the first thing that you can do is create a free listing for your vendors. Now, instead of just reaching out to them and asking them to join your community when they have no idea who you are, you can actually use the fact that you're setting up a free listing for them as a way to build trust with them, to show them how you add value without asking for anything in return. Now, once you have done that with about 60 or 70 different vendors, then what you can do is move on to the next part, which is to organize a free workshop for them. Now, the whole point behind this workshop is to really give them a preview of what the overall community could be about. So what you want to do is, first of all, figure out what are some of the big ticket pain points that your community have, that your vendors have, and that you could solve for them in this workshop. And so in the case of, say, the running directory, a big problem that I could help them solve is how to run Facebook ads for your running event. Again, you just want to have conversations with different vendors, figure out what it is that they're struggling with, and use this as a way to basically add value. Once you've reached out to the 60 or 70 vendors that already know who you are, then what you do is you invite them and run the workshop. Now, this is where it gets interesting. After you've gone through the process of running the workshop, what you want to do is you want to make your community offer. Now, the key thing here is you need to make your offer, because if you don't make an offer, you'll never find out whether or not this is something that actually anyone would want to pay for. Now, the question is, well, how does a community offer look like? Now, I created a little sample offer that you can kind of copy and paste into whatever it is that you're doing, but really, the key behind all of this is to focus on the key pain points that your community has and to basically keep the value super simple. So the way that I phrased it for, say, the running directory is to create a private online group for Canadian race directors. Now, the more specific you are here, the better, because the more specific you are, the more relevant they'll feel it is to them, and the more likely they will be to want to pull the trigger. The second thing is, add a resource library, add things like templates that they can use, checklists, you know, even like pitch decks that they might want to reuse. Again, this is something that will evolve over time, but if you can figure out what those big pain points are that you can solve for them by adding it as a resource, you have now already added another reason why they should join. Another big thing is, if your workshop goes well and people find it useful, people are asking questions, people want follow-ups, then make workshops part of your community offer. All you need to do is host one a month, and if you don't want to be the one that hosts it, just invite a guest to basically speak to a topic that is relevant to your community. Another big thing that I've seen communities do really well is, as you get to the point where your community grows, you actually have leverage that you can use to get deals for your community members. So if, for example, everyone uses the same registration platforms, you can reach out to them, get discounts for your community members. It's a really great way to leverage your community in order to add even more value to them. And then the big thing, of course, is that then you can also add as a perk a feature placement on your site. So that means they get a verified badge, they get higher visibility in the search and filtering, and ultimately now that feature that was initially going to be your primary way of making money is essentially a bonus. And so that is ultimately how you want to think about it. Keep your pricing simple, have an annual plan, have a monthly plan, and that will be more than enough to get you started. Now, how well does this business model actually scale? Now, I'm going to say before even thinking about scaling, there's an art to running a community. There are people who do it incredibly well. And I think if you want to touch on the key things that I think make for successful communities, it's one, be consistent. That is, post regularly, regularly host workshops. The second thing is really include your community members, make them feel involved in the entire process. And number three, just make sure that you're touching on the most useful things. Now, obviously people know more about this than me, but typically if you can get to the stage where you're using this to build a brand and to build trust, it makes it so much easier to then scale beyond a basic membership offer like this. Here are some examples of how you can scale into high ticket offers. So first of all, you can offer one-on-one coaching. So that is something that is going to be in high demand because a lot of times beyond the resources that are available, people will have very specific questions and they'll also be wanting to spend the money on that. Then you can offer done for you packages. So that is when you start building out specific things for them. Maybe it's create their social media content. Maybe it's build them a website, those types of things. Now we're moving from a $500 per year offer to a few thousand dollars that you can charge for a very specific thing. Also, as your network grows, you'll get more leverage, you'll get access to more people, and you can then use your network as a way to make introductions to, say, your premium members, to, you know, maybe partners or trusted vendors, whatever it may be. Then another big one, and this is the one that I think is going to be the absolute winner, organize in-person events. Doing these things online is cool, but everyone getting to meet each other in person is one, a way better experience, and two, just makes your entire community as a whole way, way stickier. Now, if you are thinking about the next tiers, you know, you can also offer exclusive access to certain parts of your circle community by creating a mastermind group. There are basically tons and tons of ways to basically go from having it be a $500 or $600 a month offer to having something where you can potentially charge 20 to 30 grand a year. So ultimately, this is a model that scales incredibly well. Ultimately, I would say if you are completely unsure about how to monetize your directory, this is probably the one that I'd start off with. You don't need a lot of technical chops. It doesn't cost incredibly much to get started. And if it doesn't work out, you haven't really lost that much money. There's not that much of a commitment that you need to make. And more importantly, it's a really fun one. If you're someone that enjoys actual community and connection to people, this is hands down the business model that will suit you the best. I'm going to be making more videos on different business models that you can use in your directory that might go beyond, you know, the standard, you know, AdSense revenue. So if you have any specific questions about this one, or you have other directories that you're working on that you'd want some recommendations for, let me know in the comments down below. Also, let me know if you found this video useful. Other than that, thank you so much for watching the entire video, and I'll see you back here for the next one.